Haryana, who is in a high-level position, although he's retired now. I still remember going to him, that was almost 12, 13 years back, and I told him that many of the girls get trafficked from the Northeast, especially Assam, into Haryana because of the sex ratio. Haryana has a sex ratio issue because most of the girl child is killed, you know. So we have a lot of girls being brought to Haryana in the form of getting married. But then the same woman, the same girl, the young girl, is used by the father, by the brother, by the uncle. So to me, that is sex slaves. To me, that's a human right violation for women. But I still remember my first encountering with him. The first thing he told me, my Punjab men are very handsome, Hasina. So if your girls in the Northeast want to get married with them, what's the problem? That, I mean, I either would have walked out, either at that point of my life, either I could have walked out, or either I would have had an argument and throw a fit because I was so angry, or I could have just said, you know, I'm so sorry, I would have, you know, all of that. My reaction at that point of time was so simple, maybe because I just started off, and I had to tell him to believe what I'm trying to sell, is the only thing I told him, I said, you have a doctor? And if your daughter is married in that situation, will you still accept? When a woman has a child in the house, and I've seen what, like, I'll just give you an example of women police and, you know, men police when I do trainings. If a woman police has a child smaller in the house, okay, and she's attending my 3 days rigorous training, and the man might have the same amount, the same child in the house, you see the woman police standing up of the class room to go out constantly. She might be in a hard position. She's so touched, like, what happened to my child right now at the house, right? Who's, no, it's always like that. And I think it happened with every woman. And that is also a drawback to our spring. We don't have to show that, you know, we can handle that very well. And to handle that very well, one needs to train our mind. That if today we have arranged somebody to look after a child in the house, whether it's a nanny or a caretaker, you know, or we kept in a crèche, we should be confident that that person is going to take care of the child very well. So that your role, your work that you're doing at that particular time doesn't get disrupted. There used to be debate in some of the trainings that I do with men, and they said, I think you should allow her to go, she has a small baby in the house. So there were questions that I told one of the commandant in the BSF. I said, but you also have a small child in the house, not willing to go home right now. So why does she have to go and why do you have to stay? Okay. But because of our outer appearance, the way we get jittery, we get disturbed, we get always disturbed what's going to happen in the house. Okay. That also becomes one drawback of the human condition.
You know, the balancing is there, home, profession, and getting whatever I wanted, but yeah, the ambition, you know, ambition. I just couldn't follow my own dreams all the time. I had to put a line somewhere because I had to think about the family somewhere. So how do women go without the understanding of the society? From this, we need that understanding from the society. We need that adjustment from the organization also where we work. So that's missing. That's missing in our society.
When kids become 15, 16. They like personal space. Okay? The moment now they're 16. 10, 11, they like personal space. Maybe in my generation, 15, 16, personal space. Now, 10, 11, 12, they want personal space. You know, even if parents don't earn so much, they don't want a room for themselves to sleep. I mean, it's a struggle for parents today, you know? They have got 3 kids to be able to give 3 rooms for them. I've seen my own nephew at 8 years. He's questioning that why he has to share the room. You know, I mean, this question comes. So what I'm trying to say is, you have to go a little bit, one step ahead. To think that when you were young, did you like to have personal space? Number one. Two, is that young person might want some personal space. So being able to pursue what you're doing and also allowing that young child to have a personal space is something which is very critical. Because at the end of the day, when your child becomes, let's say she becomes a qualified doctor one day, you look back and say, what the hell, I should have done that one. Why did I do that? I didn't take precautions at the right time.